Hi guys! This is your Korean buddy, 소라. 안녕하세요. 여러분의 한국어 공부를 도와줄 여러분의 한국 친구, 소라입니다. Okay, so today we will learn how to say various kinds of flavors in Korean. So, are you guys ready? Let's get started. Number one is 맵다. 맵다. 맵다 is just original form. And I'm going to give you original form and two kinds of conjugated forms. One is former one, the other is informal one. So 매워요 is a former phrase, 매워요. So this is conjugated to be a present tense form. So 매워요. And 매워 is informal phrase. So some of you guys know former phrases can be used when you just talk to your coworker at work or you are having conversation at a former situation. But informal phrases can be used when you talk to your friends. So I guess you guys have to study three kinds of forms together. Then you can just choose the proper one when you have a conversation. 매워요. 매워요? 매워. 매워요? 매워. Okay, then let's make a simple sentence. 이 떡볶이는 매워요. 이 떡볶이는 매워요. Means this 떡볶이 is spicy. So 매워요, 매워요. And let's make this phrase more informal. Yeah. 이 떡볶이는 매워. 이 떡볶이는 매워. So as you can see, there is no yo at the end of the sentence, right? So you just drop yo, then you can make it more informal phrase. 이 떡볶이는 매워. Okay, and there is a similar word. 매콤하다. 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 매콤하다 is original form and means slightly spicy. 맵다 can be used in both way. In a positive way, in a negative way. But 매콤하다, 매콤하다 means slightly spicy. Just is used in a positive way most of time. So 이 떡볶이는 매콤해요. 이 떡볶이는 매콤해요. So it's conjugated to be present tense. And 이 떡볶이는 매콤해. 이 떡볶이는 매콤해. So 매콤하다 is only used in a positive way. 매콤하다. And number two is 달다. 달다. Which means sweet. So 달다 is original form and 달아요, 달아요 is former phrase and 달아 is informal phrase, 달아. So here is a sentence using 달아요 and 달아. This candy, 이 candy는 달아요. 이 사탕은 달아요. 이 사탕은 달아요. And another one is 이 사탕은 달아. 이 사탕은 달아. Okay. There is a similar word too, which is 달콤하다. 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 달콤하다 is original form and 달콤해요 here and 달콤해. 달콤해요 former one. 달콤해요 is in 달콤해 is informal one. 이 케이크는 달콤해요. 이 케이크는 달콤해요. Which means this cake is also sweet. Yeah, same meaning. 이 케이크는 달콤해. 이 케이크는 달콤해. Informal phrase. But there is one difference. Even if they have the same meaning, which is sweet, but 달다 is only can be used when we describe the flavor. But 달콤하다 can be used when you describe like just noun, such as 달콤한 꿈, which is sweet dream, 달콤한 휴가, which is sweet vacation. So you can use 달콤하다 when you just describe the situation or things, these kind of things. And number three is 쓰다. 쓰다. Yeah, 쓰다. You know, 쓰다 means bitter. 쓰다 is bitter. Actually, 쓰다 has two kinds of meaning. In this case, 쓰다 is bitter. But 쓰다 has another meaning, which is right. 쓰다, 쓰다. But now we are studying flavors. So in this situation, in this case, 쓰다 means bitter, to be bitter. So 쓰다 is original form, an adjective, original form. And 써요 is conjugated to be present tense. 써요 in a former one, 써 is in former one. For example, 이 녹차는 써요. 이 녹차는 써요. Which means this green tea is bitter. An informal phrase, 이 녹차는 써. 이 녹차는 써. 이 녹차는 써. So informal phrase. Okay. And there is also a very similar phrase, which is 쌉쌀하다. 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 쌉쌀하다 means slightly bitter. So, you know, when have you ever tried the green tea cake? Green tea cake usually, yeah, when we usually say 쌉쌀하다 when we describe green tea cake. 녹차 케이크. 녹차 케이크. 녹차, so we can say like this. 녹차 케이크는 쌉쌀해요. 녹차 케이크는 쌉쌀해요. 녹차 케이크는 쌉쌀해. 녹차 케이크는 쌉쌀해. Like this. Number 4 is 시다. 시다. 시다 means sour. Sour, to be sour. So 시다 is of original form and 셔요. 셔요 is former one. 셔. 셔 is informal one. For example, 이 포도는 셔요. 이 포도는 셔요. Which means this grape is sour. 이 포도는 셔. 이 포도는 셔. Same meaning, this grape is sour. But this is informal phrase. So because there is no 요, right? So 셔. There is very similar word too. 새콤하다. 새콤하다. 새콤하다 means slightly sour. Very slightly sour. 새콤하다. So, 새콤하다 is original form and 새콤해요 in a former phrase. 새콤해 in former phrase. Then you can say like this. 이 김치는 새콤해요. 이 김치는 새콤해요. Which means this kimchi is slightly sour. 이 김치는 새콤해. 이 김치는 새콤해. All same meaning, but this is informal phrase. And there is very special word 새콤달콤하다. 새콤달콤하다. So 새콤, remember, slightly sour. 달콤, remember, 달�m is sweet, right? So 새콤달콤하다 is can be used when you describe something tastes slightly sour, also at the same time, yeah, sweet. I guess orange is 새콤달콤하다. So you can say 이 오렌지는 새콤달콤해요. 이 오렌지는 새콤달콤해요. 이 오렌지는 새콤달콤해. 이 오렌지는 새콤달콤해. You know what? We have a candy called, it's named 새콤달콤. When I was a kid, I used to eat this candy a lot. It's kind of sticky, and when you it very tastes sour, so it makes your tongue watery when you eat this candy. Yeah, anyway, so if you visit Korean, you can find it 새콤달콤 in any convenience store, any supermarket, just to try it, okay? 새콤달콤. Find this. 새콤달콤. And number 5 is 짜다. 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 Which means salty. So, 짜다, original form, 짜요, former phrase, which is conjugated to be present tense, 짜요, informal phrase, 짜, 짜, 짜. So, let's make a sentence. 이 피자는 짜요. 이 피자는 짜요. 이 피자는 짜요. Which means this pizza is salty. And informal one. Yeah, how can you make this informal phrase? Yeah, it's your turn. Try it. That's right. 이 피자는 짜. 이 피자는 짜. Yeah. And there is also, now you guess what I'm talking about, right? Yeah, there is also similar expression. 짭짤하다. 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 Yes. 짭짤하다 means slightly salty. Yeah, it's salty, but it's still good to it. So, you know, I guess most of snack, they are 짭짤하다. So, 이 과자는 짭짤해요. 이 과자는 짭짤해요. Which means, this snack is slightly salty. 이 과자는 짭짤해. 이 과자는 짭짤해. 과자 is a snack in Korean. So, 이 과자는 짭짤해. Same meaning, but for informal phrase. 이 과자는 짭짤해. And number 6 is 싱겁다. 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 싱겁다 means bland. Taste bland. So actually, when you use 싱겁다, it tastes very bland and very plain and less salty. Then you can say 싱겁다. 싱겁다. So you probably want to add some salt to your food. Not always, but mostly 싱겁다 is used in a little negative way. For in Korean, there are many kinds of soup, right? Like 미역국, 동태탕, 콩나물국, 소고기국 등등등등등. 싱거워요 is formal one. 싱거워 is informal one. So here is a sentence using 싱겁다 싱거워. 이 국은 싱거워요. 이 국은 싱거워요. Which means this soup is less salty and bland. And 이 국은 싱거워. 이 국은 싱거워. 이 국은 싱거워. Same meaning but informal phrase. 7 is 담백하다. 담백하다. 담백하다 is original form and which means, you know what? It's really hard to find an exact same word in English with 담백하다. But I'm trying. 담백하다 is very similar with 싱겁다. 담백하다 means very bland, plain, but it's very clean. Tastes clean. So 싱겁다 usually used when we describe some food in a negative way, but 담백하다 is used in a positive way. So when someone say 이 국은 담백해요. 이 국은 담백해요. Then this is just a compliment. Yeah. So 담백해요 is usually has a good meaning. 이 국은 담백해. 이 국은 담백해. 담백해. Last 8 is 고소하다. 고소하다. 아, 고소하다. 고소하다. Yeah, 고소하다 also is really hard to describe the flavor. Well, in Korean, we use sesame oil when we cook. Have you ever tried a bibimbap before? Bibimbap is kind of a dish with rice and vegetables, very kind of vegetables and red pepper paste and sesame oil. So, sesame oil, it just smells very, very, how to say, very aromatic and very roasted. When we just add sesame oil to the dishes, then it just smells 고소하다. 아, 고소해. 고소하다. 고소하다. You should try bibimbap. Yes, please try bibimbap. Then just realize, I really hope you guys to understand what 고소하다 is. Yeah, sesame oil. You can say like this. 고소하다, 고소해요 is formal phrase. 이 비빔밥은 고소해요. 이 비빔밥은 고소해요. And informal one. 이 비빔밥은 고소해. 이 비빔밥은 고소해. 고소해. Yeah, 고소해 is usually used in a positive way. Yeah, 고소해, 고소하다. And this is for today. And if you guys think this video is really helpful to study Korean, let's subscribe my channel together. Here. Here? Maybe, I don't know. Yeah. 그러면 다음 시간에 또 만나요. 그럼 안녕.